Well, hi there, Internet. My name's Court, and you've got Courtside Seats for my review of Home Sweet Home Alone. Let's do it. Home Sweet Home Alone is a family comedy from director Dan Mazur and Disney+. Film stars Archie Yates, Ellie Kemper, Rob Delaney, and Kenan Thompson. A married couple tries to steal back a valuable heirloom from a troublesome kid. I grew up with the first two Home Alones. I love the first one, even though watching it now as an adult, it seems way more sadistic than it did when I was a kid. I didn't love the second one. I was aware of the third one, never saw it. And in preparing for this review, I found out there were actually two more sequels that I was blissfully unaware of. I'm in no rush to check them out. And this one's been on my radar for a little bit, and I guess I was kind of curious about it. Maybe morbidly curious is more accurate, because I was getting the impression it was kind of a reboot. And it is, and it isn't. More than it isn't. It exists in the same universe as the original. There are numerous references to the first, and maybe to the other ones. I don't know, I don't know them very well. I won't go into detail, but the McAllisters are referenced directly. There are recurring lines of dialogue. The score is not done by John Williams, but it uses the same leitmotifs. And even that gangster flick that Kevin watches in the first one is repurposed here as a sci-fi, but with the exact same dialogue to make a joke about how remakes are never as good. It's a pretty meta and pretty lazy joke, if I do say so myself. Now, you may be getting the impression already, and you would be correct in your assumption that I did not like this movie. Admittedly, there were things that worked about it for me. Kenan Thompson was funny in his pretty small role, and I did actually get a couple of laughs in the movie. Literally, like, two. I really liked Archie Yates and Jojo Rabbit. He's pretty good here. And there are a couple of references in here just for the parents, including a pretty sweet and accurate Scarface nod that I appreciated. And what would a Home Alone movie be without a kid setting a bunch of traps for the bad guys? And I did like the way they visualized it, where Max, the sort of Kevin stand-in in this movie, was setting up his battle plan. That was kind of cool. And I liked that this movie flipped the script a little bit anyway, in that the people breaking into Max's place aren't bad people. They just want something back that he stole from them, which would get them out of financial troubles. That's pretty much all I've got for positives. Weirdly, the fact that the intruders are essentially good people is a big problem with the film. It was fun to watch Kevin maim Harry and Marv because they were bad people. They just wanted to rob his house and then flood it for fun. Here the intruders are well-meaning people, and while I didn't quite empathize with them, I understood their plight. So seeing them get essentially taken down to bones is like a little bit unfair. Another problem is there's not a single likable character in this movie. For much of it, Max is just a little jerk. Yeah, okay, he learns his lesson in the end, and we'll get to that. Pam and Jeff, played by Ellie Kemper and Rob Delaney respectively, they're not bad people, but they're annoying, they're dumb. And like I said, I understood their plight, but I didn't care about them as characters. And all of the supporting characters are even more obnoxious. Now, much like the original, this movie does try and get some heart into it by the end, but by that point I was already so tired of it, it just came across as cheesy and forced. Was the end of the original Home Alone cheesy? Yeah, totally. But the movie earned it. This one does not. And the style of humor in here felt less like a Home Alone and more like something along the lines of Jingle All the Way. Like, the jokes are really basic, it's all really bumbling. Hey, look, his pants fell off. This movie gets far too meta to the point of distraction. It's not particularly funny. It's not particularly heartwarming. It feels like an absolute retread, and yeah, while I had a couple of laughs, it came across as kind of lazy, kind of uninspired, and not particularly fun. I do think young kids will probably get a kick out of it, and while there are some jokes peppered in there for the parents, including some nostalgia, I think most parents will probably leave the kiddos to watch it and just go do something else. Now, I don't have a proprietary rating system as of yet, so I'm just trying to figure out what I'm gonna give Home Sweet Home Alone, and I think I'm gonna give Home Sweet Home Alone a 10. So, I want to know, have you seen Home Sweet Home Alone? What did you think about it? What is your favorite childhood comedy that you'd like to see remade today? Whatever your thoughts, hit the comments below. Let's discuss. If you enjoyed this review, please smash that like button and give it a share if you really enjoyed it. Just helps the video reach more people, helps the channel grow. I appreciate it very much. And hey, why not take a second, do me a favor, click subscribe and ring that bell to subscribe to my channel for more movie reviews, entertainment news, trailer reactions, all that good stuff. Hope you guys are all safe and healthy. Thanks very much for watching. I'll see you all in the next one. Take care.